Hello, my name is Charlotte Herzeel and I work at the Access Science Lab, where we look into scaling and optimizing software used within the life sciences domain. And today I'm going to talk about our latest release of LPREP, which is a tool for analyzing sequencing data. So LPREP is an established framework for analyzing sequencing data. We focus on implementing community-defined standards such as the SAM and BAM data file formats and the GATK best practices for defining sequencing pipelines. What is special about LPREP is that it has a unique software architecture that parallelizes and merges the execution of the different steps in a sequencing pipeline. We have shown in multiple publications that this greatly improves the runtime of sequencing pipelines in comparison to other tools. We also always make sure that LPREP produces identical results in comparison to the reference tools it re-implements. Because of these features, LPREP has gained a considerable user base with, for example, around 14,000 downloads via Bioconda alone. The latest version of LPREP, LPREP 5, was released in December 2020. The main new feature of LPREP 5 is the introduction of variant calling based on the haplotype caller algorithm from GATK4. This means LPREP can now execute the full pipeline as described by the GATK best practices for variant calling. And we see that our implementation is between 8 and 16 times faster than GATK4 while producing identical results. Implementing variant calling in LPREP 5 was challenging as we had to make multiple extensions to the framework and we had to come up with multiple new parallel algorithms for implementing the different phases of the haplotype caller algorithm while producing identical results to GATK4. While our main focus with LPREP has been on improving performance, we also try to simplify the user experience. At the bottom of the slide, we show the complete LPREP command for executing the GATK best practices pipeline for variant calling. It's a relatively simple command that defines the input and output BAM files, followed by the different options that implement the individual steps of the pipeline, such as sorting, duplicate marking, BQSR and variant calling using the haplotype caller algorithm. Now this command will actually execute. So let's take a look at the performance of LPREP versus GATK. The slide shows three benchmark graphs. From left to right, there is a graph for comparing runtime, peak RAM use, and peak disk use. Note that there are two sets of numbers for GATK. This is because there is a version of GATK where they optimize the dominant step, the variant calling step, and we see that this improves the runtime. However, the approach with LPREP, shown at the bottom of the graphs, performs much better, and this is because LPREP parallelizes and merges the execution of multiple pipeline steps. Concretely, LPREP executes the pipeline between 8 and 16 times faster while using 30% less peak RAM and 30% less peak disk use. And again, all while producing identical results. We have also performed a scaling experiment on Amazon Web Services where we execute the softwares on different server instances with varying CPU and RAM resources. On the left, we show a graph that compares the runtime of GATK versus LPREP. We see that GATK scales somewhat with more resources, but LPREP generally scales better. If we compare this to the graph to the right, which shows the cost of running the benchmark on a specific server, we see that the cost of GATK steeply goes up with more resources. And this is because GATK doesn't scale as well. In contrast, the cost with LPREP is more or less stable. This shows that running software faster and using more hardware resources does not necessarily have to be more expensive, provided that your software scales, which LPREP does. This is about all I have to say about LPrep 5. If you would like to learn more, please consider reading one of our papers or downloading our software from GitHub. Thank you.